Hi, today I am going to bring you a video tutorial of repairing a microwave oven which has stopped heating. This machine has 10 microwave options and grill option with upside heaters. So grill option is working, but microwave options are not working. Once I try to start a microwave option, a breaker went down in the main supply board on the wall. So let's see how to troubleshoot and repair a microwave oven. But first of all, I should warn you that do not open a microwave oven without enough knowledge about its component inside. Because microwave oven use high voltage power and it can bring a deadly electrical shock even after you disconnect the oven from wall power connection. So highly recommend that you should never remove the main cover unless you have a complete understanding of the risk, and would like to remind you that never work on a microwave oven when you are alone at home. There are so many videos in YouTube that you can get a good knowledge about the microwave oven. Please study first and open it later. But if you think you are not capable to repairing a microwave oven by yourself, or if you don't have proper tools to diagnose the errors, do not touch it and call to the professional technician. So before remove the main cover, make sure that disconnect the power from wall first. Then unscrew around the cover and gently remove the cover without touching any component or wire connection inside to troubleshoot a microwave oven. To troubleshoot a microwave oven, you must have a multimeter, an insulated Phillips screwdriver and insulated plier. First, we will identify basic components of the microwave oven inside. Number 1. This unit we call magnetron. That is the component make microwave energy. Number 2, this is the high voltage transformer which is generate high voltage for magnetron to generate microwave energy. Number 3, this is the high voltage capacitor which is dangerous as it has high voltage power deposit even after disconnect the power supply. So we have to discharge this capacitor first before touch any component. So for better view, I will show you a removed capacitor here. Then you can understand it before discharge. This is the same type capacitor. We must discharge the capacitor by shorting between these two terminals using a well insulated pliers like this. Please remember that do not touch the metallic area of the plier during the discharge process. So now we will discharge the onboard high voltage capacitor in this microwave oven by shorting the two terminals using the plier like this. If it has any voltage deposit, it will be discharged. If it is a big deposit, you will be able to see an electrical shock. But in a microwave oven, there is an automatically discharge procedure by grounding this capacitor to the chassis through a diode. So let's talk it about later. However, do it this way 2-3 times to make sure that capacitor is discharged. So now let's check where is the fault in this oven. For that you need a multimeter. Without a multimeter, it is not possible to troubleshoot a microwave oven. Let's start from the beginning. First, turn your multimeter into continue to check mode. Then we check first the main fuse on the top right corner like this. You can hear the continuity beep. It means this fuse is okay. There is another high voltage fuse between the capacitor and transformer. It is inside the cover. Remove the cover and check the fuse. It is a high voltage fuse. You can check this fuse also using the multimeter. Look, this fuse is also okay. It has the continuity beep. Put the coverlid back. If you found a blown fuse, don't take it as a simple troubleshoot, because it might be a sign of any other faulty component inside. So we have to check all the other main functioning components too before restart the machine by inserting a new fuse. Okay, now we remove the wire connection of the capacitor. Just undo the wire connection and don't forget to put marks before remove them. Otherwise you can take a photo to later understanding of reconnection. Look at this diode. That is the component used to ground the capacitor for automatically discharge. It has connected to the chassis. Diode is more safe because it has only one-way current flow. Now we check the capacitor using the multimeter. We can use same continuity test mode for this. Find any reading between these two terminals first. You can see no any beep or reading between the terminals, which is okay. It means terminals are not shorted. Next, check between each terminals and the capacitor body. Look at this, we get a reading on multimeter between this terminal and the capacitor body. It means it is short. So, we found one fault. But we can't stop diagnose and replace the capacitor right away, because any other faulty component might affect to the capacitor damaged. So let's check rest of the other components too. So we can take out the capacitor now as it is a faulty one. Same times we remove the diode. So let's check the capacitor again for make sure that it is faulty or not. You can see again it has a multimeter reading between the one terminal and the capacitor body. We can confirm that the capacitor is faulty one. We will check this diode later. I am going to check the transformer now. So, we remove the wire connection between magnetron and the transformer first. Use the same continuity test mode to check the transformer also. First, we check these primary coil terminals for the continuity. Look, it has continuity beep, which is okay. Now, we must check the continuity between each primary coil terminals and the transformer body to check is there any short. For that, we have to find a spot on the transformer body which has the conductivity, because this entire body is coated. But you can see very small soldering spots on the transformer body like this. First, check the continuity between these two spots to make sure it is the right spot for check the continuity. And then check the continuity between each terminals and the transformer body like this. We should not have any reading or beep. So you can see here no any beep or reading, which is okay. Now we can check the secondary coil terminal connections which has connected to the magnetron. Just check the continuity between these two terminals. It has continuity, which is okay. Next, check the continuity between this each terminal and the transformer body. We should not get any reading or beep, which is okay. If any reading or beep means shorted coil. You can see here no any reading or beep, which is okay. Finally, you can see this terminal here which is connected to the high voltage fuse which we talked earlier. So, check the reading of the multimeter by touching this terminal and the transformer body. Look, we get 156 ohm, which is okay. But if you get very little amount or 0 ohms, means open circuit, which is not okay. So this transformer checking was completed and it is in a good working condition. Check your transformer also in this way by paying good attention. Now we check the magnetron using same continuity test and check these two terminals first. You can hear the beep which indicate continuity, which is okay. And then check the continuity between each terminals and the magnetron body. No continuity here, which is okay. But if any continuity means short circuit of the magnetron. This magnetron is okay and working properly. Okay, finally we check the diode. You know already current flow in a diode is only into a one direction. In this diode has very high resistance. We can't check it with the multimeter directly. Because sometimes our cheap multimeters are not capable to read its resistance. So that we have to use a trick by giving it to some DC voltage using a 9 volt battery or DC 12 volt power source like this. If you use lower DC voltage source like AA battery, will not be able to get a good reading due to high resistance. Here I use DC 12 volt power source. Just plug into the wall connection and you can see it has DC 12 volt power. Now I am going to connect the positive side of the power source into the diode from anode and connect my multimeter red lead into the cathode of the diode, like this. Then multimeter black lead touch the negative surface of the power source. Now you can see reading around 9 volt, almost 3 volt drop due to high resistance. Now you can understand why we can't use low voltage power source into this test. Same time, do the reverse voltage supply test to this diode that makes sure current flow is into a one direction. Then I connect the 12 volt power into the cathode of the diode and try to get a reading by connecting the multimeter red lead into the anode and black lead onto the negative surface of the power source like this. Look at that, very small reading, almost like 0.4 volts, which is not a considerable amount. It means this diode is okay. So at the end we were able to find the faulty capacitor as the reason of this microwave oven error. We can directly replace the same type of capacitor and solve the problem. Make sure that capacitor has same figures on its content label. But for this machine I was failed to find the same size capacitor. Because this COVID-19 pandemic time we get very less Chinese stuff into the country and there is huge shortage of goods nowadays. But I found this capacitor which has same figures on its content label. But its body is bit more longer and terminal pins are also bit bigger than the original capacitor. So it brought me some additional work to replace this capacitor into my microwave oven. I will bring you another video that how I install this new capacitor into my microwave oven with the modifications. Okay, installed a new capacitor into my microwave oven with the modifications. Okay, check all the connections are reinstalled as it was before. And reinstall the back cover before power on. Okay, everything is done and let's check the machine. Okay, powered up the machine now. I will put a cup of water into the check the microwave options after repair. Set the timer as 1 minute and start to work. Okay, done. Let's check, is it hot? See, it is steaming. Great, it works. So you can repair your microwave oven by yourself. But I remind you again, it is dangerous and do it carefully after study. Thank you for watching.